Good afternoon. I'd like to call to order the meeting of the ICCA of Wednesday, January 18th. Auburn Hills?
Here.
Berkeley?
Here.
Clawson?
Here.
Ferndale?
Here.
Huntington Woods?
Here.
Oakland Township?
Here.
Pleasant Ridge? Rochester?
Here.
Royal Oak?
Here.
And Troy is here. We will do consideration of the minutes from November 16th. Do I have a motion?
Madam Chair, I move to approve the meeting minutes from November 16th, 2016.
Do I have a second?
Support.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Treasurer's report, Tony?
Well, we're at the end of another calendar year, somewhat our fiscal year and calendar year at the same time. That's pretty good. I like that. And there's two sheets. I mean, typically you get a trial balance, which is pretty boring because there's not a lot on it, which is in a portrait mode here, this one. And then the other one is a expense and revenue sheet that shows individual items 12/31/2016. And obviously when you get to the end of the fiscal year or the end of the calendar or whatever your budget year is, you take a look at this and you try and ascertain some things. I mean, one of which is obviously how did we do in relation to revenues. And you can see at the top of the page, if you're looking at that 12/31/2016 report where it says revenue and expenditure at the top, the year-to-date balance was $25,991. And you can see it's the second column over. That's the amount of money that we had received. The interesting thing is if you look below at the very bottom there, there's maybe three-quarters of the way down the expenditure, in the second row as well, there's a figure that equals $18,541. So the $18,541 is less one large thing that's not yet posted here in this particular sheet, and that is a payable for what is the remaining portion of the Plant Moran audit, which is about $18,000. So it'll use up mostly what we had allocated for expenditures. The good news about this is that I will reiterate, as I've said 100 times here, is that we sip away at expenses here very, very well. Sip away. And we don't spend a lot of money. So I'm hoping that when all this is said and done, that our fund balance gets bumped up just a teeny little bit, and that in the next year, hopefully, depending on what this board determines to do, we may be able to maybe just one more year ask for membership fees for the next couple of years, or maybe reduce those a bit. Remember, we went through a lot of trauma here in the last year with, you know, one of our member communities and so forth. And in the end, after looking at this and dealing with this on a day-to-day basis, a lot of the work is done pro bono, and we do very well. I dare say that in my time doing this with umpteen different cities and jurisdictions and such, we don't spend a lot of money. That's the good news. And so in the end, right now we have the audit going on. I've already sent in what is called the prepared by client listing to Doran Mayhew, who's doing the audit. I just talked to the auditor today. All the baseline work has been completed, and they are now working on reviewing the audit. I just sent some information again today. So, and of course, that work, just so that the TV community can know, and of course this board knows, is that is done by the City of Huntington Woods for no cost. So that's a good thing, and I think it's something that we need to be very happy about, whoever that may be, whatever community might do that work. It happens to be our city right now. And so all the audit preparation is done, all the journal entries are made, and the auditors are reviewing all of that data as we speak. And the last piece is, I believe, once the last journal entries are posted, which have been posted and don't show up on this particular sheet, that $18,000 will probably be near zero, because we would have then allocated that expense to what is that payable for Doran Mayhew. But we'll see what happens. Typically, if you don't spend a amount of money that's due in a payable situation in the first 30, 60 days or so, then it ceases to become a payable in the first place. That gets into, obviously, accounting standards and so forth. But I think we probably will, and therefore I'm making the assertion here, the assumption that that $18,000 will go away, or that we will have spent it, I should say. So, but that's it. So more later on the audit. Everything looks good. Everything sent in, and hoping that we can have all of that rolling for the next meeting.
Sounds good. Any questions for Tony? Okay, we'll receive and file. Consideration of the following report, CMN. We have Chris here. Everybody should have got his report that I sent.
Welcome back. So over the last month and a half or so, I met with various people from our wonderful cities and worked with them a bit. Worked with Stephanie, of course, on preparing the RFP for the playback system upgrade that we had recommended earlier in the fall. And it the bids come in, and I believe the council votes on it next week.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully that'll get approved, and then we'll help them install the playback system to match what Oakland Township has. Worked with Oakland Township a bit on some of their audio issues in their video room, and some of their troubles they have getting PowerPoint presentations onto the laptop so the audience can see them. People are still terrified of flash sticks in 2017, but we're going to find a way to overcome that fear. And we've offered a number of solutions and quotes to Jamie we're working with to fix all that. And I met with Anthony and Blaine in Rochester, who have, once again, audacious plans to renovate City Hall and upgrade the video equipment. So I provided them with four quotes on what they can do to revolutionize video systems in their City Hall. And we're going forward with some options that they and the City Council will decide in the next few weeks. So there's lots of stuff with the cities along those lines. Insofar as what's going on here, oh, one more about Berkeley. Molly and Chelsea worked on streaming options for the meetings in Berkeley. For a while, they've been using Ustream, the free account, which puts annoying commercials in the middle of their meetings. So they had Chelsea looked up some other providers. We tested them multiple times. Didn't have a lot of luck, and we're testing out another solution, possibly with the city's Facebook page, and we're waiting on the update to Berkeley's website to implement some of that that will work with our TriCaster. So we have some other options available, and hopefully in February, Chelsea said your website should be relaunched. Yep. And the new streaming options will be there without commercials in them. We'll see. Around here, what have we done? Probably the biggest thing, in early November, I said we switched over to a new playback system, the same one we recommended Oakland Township and in Auburn Hills. So the channel's been running on that and streaming on that since then. Also, when people turn in shows to us, they've had for years to fill out a physical piece of paper, playback request form with details on their program and signing it, taking responsibility for what they air. And then we have to turn those into a report that we give to our board each month. So there was a lot of typing by interns and employees to put all that into a spreadsheet. So finally, Kevin and I worked out a system. So the playback request form is now online on our website. It's electronic. It's also here on a dedicated computer in the lobby. And so we've just started switching everyone over to typing them in themselves. So it's all electronic, saving a lot of typing time. I'd say like 95% of the people are actually doing that now. We're still getting a few paper forms, but that's really, really helpful. And coordinating that was somewhat of an effort. We had a hard drive crash in EdSuite A, but I went to a firm called Secure Data Recovery in Troy, and they're working on the recovery of those files. They're at 50% recovery, and they should be available the second week of February, and they even gave us a nonprofit discount for the pricing. It was very good. That fit in with the budget the CMN-TV board approved for that. So that was good. In coordination with that, we developed a new backup strategy for all the staff edit suites, because they all take a hand in editing stuff for the cities throughout the whole building. We had some backups, but we've reinforced and duplicated and triplicated everything. So each edit suite has everything backed up multiple times. case of disaster. We're also in the middle of redoing the truck. The CMNTV board approved last 2 years money to reorganize the truck. We have been removing everything, inventorying every piece from the truck, and in communications with various vendors for quotes to reorganize it and make it one, more useful, two, more habitable in regards to the temperature, especially, and three, more understandable, because when we go to the schools to teach the students the different positions right now, the layout doesn't really make much sense, but it will have very clearly defined seats and positions for them to take a part of, hopefully by May or June. So things are underway for that. And I believe those are the big ones. CMNTV's board approved our budget, which begins now in January. And I've spoken also with Judy Davids about the Royal Oak Show. And James, if you'd like to stick around, I can show you some stuff from that. And we're going to plan out meetings to produce that in 2017.
Sounds good.
I believe that's all for now.
Any questions for Chris? Thank you, Chris. And today we have Leslie Brogan from Comcast. We haven't had her here for a while, go up to the mic and let us know what's happening with Comcast.
Good afternoon, everybody. It's nice to see my familiar faces and to meet everybody else. I just wanted to come, say hello, tell you a few things that are happening in Comcast, particularly our community investment side, and answer your questions. I have with me these very nifty little red information carriers, just about one of the programs that I'm going to be talking about. So
I bet Chris would give them out for you.
Oh, Chris, that would be great. Thank you. Want to do there as well. Okay, so, you know, Comcast does a lot with our communities as far as investing, sponsorships, programs. And one of our most premier initiatives is something called Internet Essentials. I know some of you have heard of it, but I'm not sure all have. It's I was around when we first started it, and it's already 6 years ago. So we're in our sixth year. And what this program is, it's really the nation's largest, most comprehensive program to provide high-speed internet to low-income households. And it's nationwide. We started out 6 years ago by having eligibility be families with children who were participating in the free federal school lunch program. Over the years, we've kind of broadened the scope to allow more families in. And just this year, we took a really big step to include not only the families with children, but people who are living in HUD-assisted housing or public housing, which takes in a very different demographic group. We get the seniors, we get veterans, we get adults without children. So right now in Michigan, we have connected over 750,000 families. And if you use the multiplier, we usually use four people for family. You can see that's like 3 million people. The program is high-speed internet for $9.95 a month. You can get a computer for $150 if you so choose. You get a voucher for it. We don't give the computers. We contract with vendors. And the computers come internet-ready with virus protection and scope engines and the whatnot. And there's also training. And the training can be had, we have classroom training, but we also have it online. And the thing I'd like to stress is that you don't have to be a Comcast customer to get the training online. You can go to our website and you can access different pieces. So in the bag that I gave you, I have some of the information about the program, and it talks about how many people have signed up and over the years, what have you. But you also have an insert that has Arabic lettering. And this is, we have translated literature and the training into 14 different languages. And this was largely based on what our schools told us about the pupil attendance and how many diverse groups were there. So we've done that. We have, you know, tried to appeal to different age groups by doing things like internet safety. We have training in print material and also in videos. You know, Comcast, in the Comcast family is NBC. And we have been able to use on-air talent to talk about how to do things on the internet, which makes it a little bit more interesting for some. Talking about things like how you set up your email or how you keep your identity safe or how you access resources online. And it's in this day and age, really, we feel everybody has to be digitally literate. So without going on and on, as I could for probably a day, about the program, I want to keep on the topic of digital literacy and talk about another initiative that was highlighted last week in the press, and that is in Michigan, the Comcast Foundation gave out over $350,000 to nonprofits who have some kind of a digital literacy program. They work with youths, they work with training, they work with computer skills, and so that was given out last week. And there are several in your community here. Let me see if I have that list handy. Among those that received this money was the Urban League of Detroit and Southeast Michigan, Boys and Girls Club of Southeastern Michigan, Boys and Girls Club of Oakland and Macomb Counties, and the Girl Scouts of Southeast Michigan. And that's just to name a few. We usually do these grant announcements every year. And finally, one of the other programs I wanted to make you aware of that we've done for many, many years now is the Leaders and Achievers Program. And this is where we give a $1,000 scholarship to high school seniors who have displayed either academic excellence or they're very active in their community or leadership skills. And principals are the ones who recommend these applicants. So it's not us, it's the principals. And this year, again, there are some students in your communities who will be receiving that $1,000 scholarship at an event we do, usually at the Capitol. Sometimes that varies depending on scheduling, but that usually happens in the spring. So that's about all I think I want to give you on our community investment side.
From our communities, right? So that'll be coming.
Will. Yes, we will.
Yeah.
We will do that. Yep. We have to wait because while all of the students have been notified, we have to wait for their acceptance. Mm-hmm. It's rare they don't accept, but there have been a few instances. So we're kind of sensitive to that and just want to wait. Want to wait for that. Other than that, we're very busy improving our products, our services, our customer experience. And if you have any questions that I could try to answer, I would be glad to.
Anybody have some questions for Leslie?
More of a comment than anything. Well, a couple things. First of all, in our world now, Comcast is very large. It really is. I mean, let's face it, you can't do anything anymore without dealing with digital technology in the home. And to suggest, you and I had this discussion, this has been 2.5 years ago now, with regards to the senior population and so forth. It was at a meeting you had in Southfield. And I indicated to you that I thought this is really somewhere that you need to really put your talons into and help these individuals who are lower income deal with this. It had nothing to do with me suggesting that. It was all Comcast, but I'm delighted to see that, in fact, this has happened because it's exactly what we need to have happen. Even in Huntington Woods, as one would think that they've got so much money they don't know what to do with themselves, you'd be surprised how many people struggle. And so this is a great thing. Is it something Comcast should do? Of course it's something Comcast should do, but it's easy not to do it. Comcast has done it. And so I am absolutely delighted. Second thing is that we typically don't have you here that often. And years ago, of course, we did. And so I just want to simply say that even though we don't see you as often, boy, I'd like to see you all the time. You've always been available to us. I must say that I've never had an occasion, not one time ever, that I didn't send an email to you. And this is this honest to goodness. And I have hundreds of emails that I have to deal with every day. And some of these folks know how pathetic I am with dealing with them. But I'll tell you this, is that you have always been able, you've been available. That is a good thing. And I mean, to me, that is everything. Because when I get a complaint out there, all of these people do. They're here all the time telling us about things and so forth. But you do get back to us. Certainly to me, I'm sure that's the case also right away. And so I am just delighted about that, really. So both on the low-income program situation, which I think, Leslie, I can't begin to tell you how important that is, and the fact that you are very able to get back with us in your busy schedule and do the things you're supposed to do in terms of making sure you make that connection to these local communities. So kudos to you on that.
Thank you.
You bet.
Anybody else? Yep, I'd like to say exactly. When I send her an email or call her, I have a customer of theirs that's having an issue. She responds right away. So thank you for that. Because, right, who do our customers call? Who do our residents call but us?
But us.
Right.
That's right. That's so, right.
Definitely. Thank it's you. Been the same for us, too, Rochester. Been no shortage of quite a few of them over the years, but it's been great. I mean, it's
well, thank you.
So
you're
done.
Also very good to work with all of you around here, so yeah. It's a two-way street.
Thank you. Teamwork.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming.
Okay. Well,
maybe we'll see you in March.
Thank you.
And Ken Parson from WOW was going to come, but his he had a medical situation in his family. He just wanted to tell you all that they are expanding in 2017. They're adding three new cities: Livonia, Farmington, and Grosse Pointe Shores. So WOW is growing as well. AT&T, there's nobody here. So old business, we'll talk about the CMN contract. I received not a lot, but some comments from people and things that, you know, little adjustments. And I also added that this board approved for CMN to... They only have to have the full audit every other year, and then it's the review on alternate year. So I did that, add that under Section 15A in case you didn't catch it, because it does save them some money, and we thought that was okay. But everything else, we took everything into account, which everybody talked about, and anybody have any comments, or will we have a motion to approve our contract?
Motion to approve.
I would support that, Madam Chair. I think that I think this group has done exactly what they said they were going to do.
Mm-hmm.
I've said that before. And if it weren't for your efforts, I'm not sure we would be here. And so hard work does pay off. And in this case, this group has now become exactly what it was going to be 25 years ago. And again, you know, Huntington Woods is the one that's latent here. We're not to the party yet. We need to be. And I've said that to you as well. It's up to our commission to do so. But the communities now that have you do taping and programming and so forth and so on, that's an amen. This is exactly where we need to be. Congratulations. And I'm glad to second the motion.
Anybody else? Any comments? So all in favor?
Aye.
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 Opposed? All right, motion passed unanimously. So we're good till 2022.
Holy
cow. We'll
the future. Thank
we'll
you.
Will we be here? Chris will be here. Thank you, Chris.
Thank you.
Cable provider audit update. Tony, were you going to give a little?
No, other than I think I sent you, Madam Chair, and I don't know is
you.
If...
Did,
maybe what we ought to do is maybe Chris,
could
you
make
a couple copies of these for me? This for me, and I'll just simply say that we had some difficulty getting some information, as you know, but I think that they've picked up their game quite a bit. So I am hoping as I said earlier, with the expenditure stuff, in the next month that we will have enough data to be able to complete that process. So I talked to Beth Bailey from Plant Moran, and I don't know if our legal counsel has had any communication at all, but as far as I'm concerned, I think they're at the end of the work that they have to do. It was delayed because they simply couldn't get some information from one of the providers. But so although I don't have anything concrete to report, I don't want to be disingenuous to you on that. Read this letter when you get it back, and it'll give you some sense of where we are.
And I think that's been our issue is it's not our audit, it's not our our auditors, it's the cable companies. It's trying to get the information from them.
Unfortunately, because of the state statutes pertaining to cable doings in Michigan in the last 10 years, it has been more and more difficult to do the things we need to do. And this, and I'm sure our legal counsel at some point can illustrate that in other ways, but it makes it more difficult for us to, the term is not force the issue, but to go a little further mm-hmm. with this. So,
thank you, Tony. We didn't have any new business. Any legal counsel report?
Nothing at this time.
Okay. Any public discussion? Authority member comments? Stephanie?
I just want to thank Chris and his team again for all their help with the upgrade our AV room. It's been interesting to sort of learn the process, and our council will be voting on the new playback system on Monday, as Chris indicated. And so just a big thanks for that again.
Good. He came into the room right when she was saying
right wow. How there. About that, huh?
Jamie?
Same thing. I'd like to thank Chris and Kevin. We're making some upgrades to our room, too. Even in November and December, when we had a light meeting schedule, you still recorded 14 meetings for us. So thank you for all that you do.
Dave?
Darshelle?
Just to say thanks to Chris for helping us out on some short notice things. It's hard when you are a small city and you're really willing to have enough coverage for everything. And you've always been very responsive to us. I appreciate that. Thank you.
Marty? Nothing. Thank you. Anthony?
Echoing the same thing, thank you so much for the doing the quotes and getting all of our many issues straightened out. And cool news is we're starting to make some progress on some of those items. So we're kind of cherry-picking for a little bit, but it's a very, very old system. The hamster's about ready to retire, so we're going to need to bid out a new hamster or hopefully start getting some newer equipment in there. So we're getting there, but it's been great getting all the expertise and help getting that put together.
Good. James?
Just looking forward to seeing what Chris and the team are putting together for the Royal Oak TV show.
Ooh, good. Cool.
Tony?
Two things. I think that, Darshelle, you said it exactly right. That is, the help of this team here doing the things that you do as good as you do in Berkeley is exactly what the future is. I've said that a minute ago. Five communities are already involved. I think at some point Huntington Woods may be, as I said a moment ago. I think that's exactly what needs to happen. And so, great work. Again, please read the letter from Plant Moran. If you folks have any questions about that, I'll send them off to Beth Bailey or their Plant Moran team to see if I can get them answered and see if we can get something concrete to you rather than just a bunch of hubbaloo talk here. So
maybe by our March meeting we'll be pretty good. So I echo the Chris Love Fest and Kevin and your everybody here is fabulous. I'm glad all of our communities are working so well together, and we look forward to five more great years. So if there's anything else, do we have a motion to adjourn?
To move.
Support.
All right. All in favor?
Aye.
Meeting adjourned.